Hello, I'm Blake Ress, Commissioner of the Indiana High School Athletic Association. Today, I'd like to tell you about a friend to the more than 160,000 student athletes in the state of Indiana, Farm Bureau Insurance. In their own low-key way, Farm Bureau Insurance has played a key role in the success of high school athletic programs throughout the state. Since joining the IHSAA as its exclusive corporate partner in 1988, Farm Bureau Insurance has contributed more than $3 million in support of high school student athletes. On behalf of all the member schools of the IHSAA, we would like to take this opportunity to thank Farm Bureau Insurance for its support of our young people.
To most of the country, it is just a game. But for Hoosiers, this is the time where our fondness for basketball has its yearly renewal. It is a time when the spirit of the student athlete has been entrusted with our passion of sport and the pureness of its competition. A time where hard work is rewarded, not with wealth and riches, but with the smiles and the tears of a lifetime. Where a simple game played by young adults can inspire generations. Today we celebrate the 100th annual IHSAA Boys State Finals, and it's next on the Indiana Cable Network. Good morning and welcome to a full and fun day of basketball here at Conseco Fieldhouse. Yes, it is the 100th annual IHSAA Boys Basketball Championship Games, and we start with the single-A matchup, Barr-Reeve and Bowman Academy. Thank you so much for joining us on the Indiana Cable Network. Greg Rakestraw joined by former Indiana University basketball player and coach and Dan Dockich. And Dan, something we rarely have in a championship game, a match of the teams ranked number one and number two in the state.
Yeah, and it's great, but two contrasting styles. Bowman Academy, they're going to get out and go number one in the state in scoring at 85 points a game. Barr-Reeve, on the other hand, ninth in defense, no matter the class. Bowman Academy wants to go. Barr-Reeve wants to slow it down. It's going to be a great, interesting matchup.
Let's again show you how these two teams got here. We'll start with the Vikings of Barr-Reeve. Got by nemesis Lagodi and North Davies in sectional play. Knocked off Lanesville in the regional championship game. And a semi-state victory over North Central of Farmersburg at Seymour last week. And their key player, Dan, is the coach's son, Trey Hughes.
Yeah, what a shock in the state of Indiana. The coach's son would be the key player. He's getting 17 a night. He has to do that, but also has to lead. When Bowman goes on one of those runs and really comes after him, Trey Hughes has to lead the basketball team, make sure everybody's calmed down. That's going to be big today.
Now for the Bowman Academy Eagles, they've been checking scoreboard lights across the state. Triple digits in their opening two games. They've cleared 86 in five of their six tournament games. They knocked off Monroe Central last week, and Christopher Bond is their leader on the court.
Christopher Bond, 6'6", 18-12. He'll go to the offensive glass. He's relentless. And don't forget DeJuan Marrero. A lot of college coaches coming to see this sophomore, considered one of the best in the country.
Our Shelbourne Knee Center keys to the game come your way next. Pre-game game continues momentarily. You're watching the IHSAA Championship Games on the Indiana Cable Network. You can see Conseco Fieldhouse. About time for the first of our four state championship games today on the Indiana Cable Network. First up, the single-A matchup between Barr-Reeve and Bowman Academy. Time now for our keys to the game brought to us by the Shelbourne Knee Center. Dan, let's start with Bowman Academy.
Well, Bowman Academy wants to get out and go, and they also want to press, so they have to establish the fastest pace possible. Get the 50. What that means is this, Greg. Bowman Academy shoots 50 shots a game. Now, that's a ton. So, again, the pace, getting up and down the floor, getting a ton of shots, and doing that by not only getting steals and layups, but getting second shots in half court.
And now for Bryan Hughes, Barr-Reeve Vikings.
Well, the Vikings have to get to all the 50-50 balls. What that means, Greg, you and I are going for the basketball. I have a shot at it. You have a shot at it. Who's going to get it? The Vikings have to get those balls. What that does, it limits layups, it limits fouls, and it limits kick-out threes. Also, make Bowman beat you with the first shot, not the second or third or fourth shot. Bowman is going to attack the glass. If the Vikings can keep him off the glass, make Bowman beat him with only one shot per possession, they've got a real shot here tonight.
Starting lineups and opening tip-off comes your way next from downtown Indianapolis. You're watching the 100th annual IHSAA State Finals on the Indiana Cable Network. Welcome back to Conseco Fieldhouse. Now you see a beautiful establishing shot, as we call it, of our actions and activities today. And there's better light out there than you see in here right now, because the starting lineups are being introduced for the Bowman Academy Eagles. They are the home team, wearing the home whites today at Conseco. Starting lineups have already been given for Barr-Reeve. Let's show you who's going to be starting today for those Barr-Reeve Vikings. We mentioned again the fact that Trey Hughes is their key player, again, the coach's son and their leading scorer. Christian Duncheon is their biggest player at 6'3". A very balanced starting five. Again, they'll play a 7 or 8 man rotation today, but these are the guys who are going to have to get it done, Dan, if Barry's to hang in this basketball game.
And what getting it done means is handling the basketball. Don't turn it over. Nothing easy for Bowman Academy. And also, watch this. When the shot goes up, watch the guards for Barr-Reeve. They have to be involved at getting the basketball off the board.
Bryan Hughes is the head coach of the Barr-Reeve Vikings. Again, this is his 25th season as the head coach, or as a high school head coach, his 18th year at Barr-Reeve. The semi-state championship victory for Bryan for Barr-Reeve was his 300th at the school. Now for the home squad, the Bowman Academy Eagles, again, just their third year of varsity competition, their second year eligible for an IHSAA state championship event. Bond their leading scorer, but it's Moore and Robinson, Dan, that kind of make this engine go in the backcourt.
Tyrae Robinson, number 5, is as fast as there is in the state at getting the ball down the floor. He can score, he can finish, he finds others. He is an absolute key tonight, or this afternoon, in the basketball game.
And the head coach is Marvin Rea, his third year as the head man at Bowman Academy. As we mentioned, their third year playing varsity basketball. 55-12 is Marvin's record at Bowman, and if he is the winning coach today, it's a bit of Indiana High School Athletic Association history. He'd be just the second coach to have won a Trestor Award as a player and won a state championship as a coach.
And people will remember him. He went to Purdue as a walk-on for Gene Cady and the Boilers.
Tap is up. The Barr-Reeve Vikings have the basketball in the 100th annual boys basketball state finals are underway, and Bowman on the attack. Zone pressure immediately.
They need to get the basketball into the middle to break this and then look opposite.
Willie Helms on the handle. Ball was tipped away, taken away by Silk Joseph, but Barr-Reeve gets it right back. Again, Bowman Academy wants to make this thing up and down. Barr-Reeve wants a half-court basketball game. Hughes for three. Rebound position, Duncheon. One dribble, had it blocked by Joseph, got it back again. Left hand does not go. Fight for the loose ball, and Bonds got it for the Bowman Eagles.
That is absolute great effort by Duncheon, but against Bowman, you got to score when you get opportunities like that.
DeJuan Marrero cannot get his shot to go, and Willie Helms, young man will be a Marine in 3 months with a basketball for Barr-Reeve.
I tell you, I kind of like the look as they throw it to me right now.
Your hands are still in midseason form.
I kind of like the look of Barr-Reeve. It's absolutely no intimidation. I would like to see them get a guy in the middle of the zone, though.
This is their third state championship appearance in single A. They were runners-up in 2002, as well as in 2007. 0-2, they lost to Rossville. In 2007, they lost to Oregon Davis. Christopher Bond to the basket, and Bowman's on the board, 1 minute in.
That's what Bond is going to do. He's going to slash, he's going to rebound, he's going to take it at the rim.
So full court pressure. We'll see this all game long from Bowman. This is 2-2-1 variety here. Turnover, Barr-Reeve. Third turnover so far by the Vikings. Marrero, Bond, block, rebound, no, fight for the loose ball, and Barr-Reeve's got it. But Bowman's getting the looks they want here early.
Yeah, Marrero's not going to miss that too often. One thing Barr-Reeve has to do is look to skip pass, throw it diagonal. Right here, 20 is wide open on a reverse.
This is Hughes on the high right side. Here comes the pressure. Triple through it, and now play to an advantage. Left baseline corner, three, no good. Shot missed by Wagler. Fight for the loose ball off Marrero. Out of bounds to Barr-Reeve.
What you saw right there, Greg, every time the ball is going to go into the middle against this Bowman Academy defense, you're going to see an open shot opposite. But you got to make it.
It's Duncheon who receives the inbounds pass. Hughes all the way in, left-handed scoring. Barr-Reeve's on the board.
Can't be passive against Bowman Academy. That was a great play by Hughes. If you're standing around and you're passive, they'll get a deflection. Hughes just took it at the rim.
Well, in talking with Bryan Hughes on Monday at the state finals media session, he said, if you turn down open looks once you beat the pressure, you're missing your best shot you're going to get the entire trip.
He's absolutely right.
Three for Bowman, up and no good. Missed by Tyrae Robinson. Barr-Reeve has the basketball.
But to Coach Hughes' point, you have to be selective also. You have to know when it's absolutely there and when it's not there.
Nick Moore, 5'10 senior, will pick up the foul. Let's take a look at Barry's first points of the afternoon.
Well, right here, when there's a lot of pressure at the point of a zone, the other guys have a tendency at the bottom of the zone to get man-oriented. So if you can beat the initial pressure, many times, we saw Butler do this the other night against Syracuse, many times you can get to the rim.
Nels picks up his dribble in a bad spot. Duncheon, though, is able to save it inbounds to Brandon Graber. Right baseline corner, three, Wagner up and no good, and Bond skies for that rebound. And drives the basket, draws the foul, will shoot two.
If I'm Coach Hughes for Barr-Reeve right now, I'm not too upset. I've had two great looks, but this again, showing it on replay, this is what we talked about in pregame with Christopher Bond. He is athletic, he's a slasher. He's not a tremendous ball handler out on the floor, but he's an excellent ball handler, 1-2 dribbles from the wing, going to the basket.
Bond averaging 18 points and 12 rebounds a game. He is a 65% free throw shooter. This Bowman Academy squad, a 61% free throw shooting team. They come in averaging 85 points a night. Bond hits them both. He's got all four Bowman points. Near steal by Robinson. Duncheon trying to fend him off. Using it, needs to get in the front court quickly, and we'll break the 10-second line. And now, right idea, maybe a little bit too much with a behind-the-back pass. That's the fourth Barr-Reeve giveaway in the first 3 minutes.
He did a great job, Hughes did, of staying low to beat pressure. And you have to stay low when you're around the rim, make a bounce pass or shot fake. He jumped up in the air, nothing good happens.
Barr-Reeve a man-to-man, and right to the basket, up and in for Tyrae Robinson. Robinson, their second leading scorer for the Eagles. He is a 15-point-a-game scorer, and a foul will be called against Silk Joseph, his first and the team's second.
Well, you can see real quickly with Tyrae Robinson there, Greg. He has a lot of dribble. You'll see here, he is going to shoot. Well, we caught it a little bit late, but prior to that layup, made an excellent hesitation dribble. If you're defending the hesitation, you always stay in a stance. Robinson has a lot with the ball.
And a foul going to be called on the reach. The foul will go against Tyrae Robinson, his first, team third. This is a Bowman team that obviously their starting five is pretty good. Kevon Ford, their sixth man, averages 9 a game. But they'll really play 9, 10, 11 guys today. So foul trouble shouldn't affect them as much.
No, they'll bring the whole city. I mean, they'll bring everybody. But I'll tell you what, Barr-Reeve's doing a nice job against pressure of making the last 3 feet of the pass theirs. They're meeting their pass, and it's cost Bowman two fouls already.
2-3 pressure zone defense, and a blocking foul is coming up here on Nick Moore. That is going to be his second foul. So four fouls called here in the first, 3-26 against the Bowman Eagles.
Well, you see the pressure. Bowman Academy, as you just said, plays a lot of guys. They don't mind fouling. They may be mind fouling way out there. But Nick Moore's an aggressive guy, and that's what Marvin Rea teaches.
Kevon Ford now checks in wearing number 0 for Bowman. 8.5 points and 2 rebounds a basketball game. Duncheon in the baseline corner for Barr-Reeve. Again, here comes immediate pressure. Hughes drives, floats, misses. Fight for the loose ball. Graber with it. Shot rejected by Marrero. Willie Helms with it now, and that is good.
Great use of the shot fake by Willie Helms in traffic.
Joseph on the drive, left hand no. Fight the loose ball, Marrero. One dribble, put back, no. Wagler with it for Barr-Reeve. And Bowman's getting point blank looks. They're just not hitting here early on. Duncheon, nice drive, but Bond is there to play a racer.
Great offense by Barr-Reeve, but even better defense by Bond.
And a reach in foul coming here on Willie Helms of Barr-Reeve. It'll be the first foul called against the Vikings this morning.
You know, on the other end, we talked about the diagonal pass. Terrific diagonal pass. Really nice shot fake from Barr-Reeve. Christopher Bond just threw it there.
The action frenetic early on, but low scoring. Eagles lead by 2. Single A final on the Indiana Cable Network. Welcome back on the Indiana Cable Network. Bowman Academy with the early lead over Barr-Reeve. Greg Rakestraw, Dan Dockich with you here on ICN. And if you're Bryan Hughes right now, Dan, what are you telling your kids from the first 4 minutes and 19 seconds?
You're telling your kids you're off to a great start. Not necessarily in the score, they're down 2. but they're off to a great start in terms of their look. Both teams have missed shots in close, but right now Barr-Reeve is out-rebounding Bowman Academy, and Coach Hughes has to be very excited about that.
If you're Marvin Rea, do you change much of anything? Because, again, you're getting great looks. You're just missing point-blank shots.
The one thing, if I'm Marvin Rea, I tell my kids to stay down. They've left their feet on shot fakes. They've over-recovered a couple times. Make Barr-Reeve score over you instead of through you and around you.
Look at Marvin on the Bowman Academy sidelines. One of two Gary schools to make the state finals today. Gary Wallace, of course, will play in the 3A game against Washington. That one is up and no good. And the rebound controlled by Barr-Reeve Helms. And we have two matchups of a Gary school versus a school from the greater Washington area today.
You know,
floater.
You know I'm from the region, so I like three teams from up there being down there. That was a great play by Hughes. Hughes, very confident kid, Greg.
You are a region expert today, unquestionably. Three-point attempt by Kevon Ford. Will not go, and Willie Helms is there for the rebound. And if I'm Bowman, that shot may have been a little bit quick because I think you can get good looks at the basket about every trip down.
Marvin Rea needs the ball reversed a few times, and then you drive it. You certainly don't need a one-pass three. It's not their strength.
Helms in the baseline corner for the Barr-Reeve Vikings. This is Trey Hughes, who more than likely will be playing at Vincennes University next season. Of course, not far from Barr-Reeve. And we have a foul going to be called on a hold away from the basketball on Tyrae Robinson. And now Robinson and Moore each have two fouls for Bowman Academy.
That's big. Marvin Rea was trying. He was trying very hard to limit fouls by backing his defense off that possession. They played it inside the three-point line. But even though he tried to limit it, Bowman's so aggressive, play so physical, they still foul.
Elijah Rea, a 6'6 sophomore, has entered for Bowman Academy, as has Cameron Madison, a 5'10 senior. Rea wears 34. Madison wears number 3. Bowman again, a zone out of the out-of-bounds play. Duncheon on the drive to the basket and scoring. Barr-Reeve's in front.
Barr-Reeve is going at the basket. They're going north and south, not east and west. You go east and west against Bowman, they steal it. North and south, Bowman's broken down.
A heads-up play by Duncheon. You would expect that from the senior class valedictorian at Barr-Reeve High School. And Duncheon, a little more basketball IQ, finds that loose ball and grabs the rebound. You said win the 50-50 balls. Barr-Reeve just got one.
And they've been doing it all game. They've been great with picking up loose balls.
Hughes thought about the pick and pop. We'll get it over to Helms on the left side. Bowman going man-to-man. Helms right to the basket. And again, Kevon Ford had other ideas, out of bounds to Barr-Reeve.
A really good play on both ends. Barr-Reeve taking the ball straight at the basket. But Kevon Ford, he's a little bit beat. Great defensive play. Gets the block, takes a good angle. Good play on both sides.
This is Wagler in the right corner. Head fake and drive. Duncheon's pass is tipped. Great passing lane play by Madison. Drives back, takes contact, and will get two fouls. That's, again, the speed that kills from Bowman Academy.
And it's also going east and west. You don't want to go east and west, particularly off balance. It's like a quarterback throwing off his wrong foot into the middle of the field. Bowman Academy has great closing speed. And if you lob the ball or you throw a soft pass, it's going to be stolen. And if it's stolen, it's going to be a layup or a foul or both on the other end.
So Madison in the free throw line, and that will be our first donation from Taco Bell today. For every free throw made today, Taco Bell will donate $10 up to $500 to the IHSAA Centennial Scholarship Award. Madison on the season, a 57% free throw shooter. Beats his average, hits them both, and we're tied at 8. Madison, the senior, averages 2 points a game off the bench.
Again, you see here, Bowman Academy has backed off the trap. What Barr-Reeve has to do is right there. Do things like back cut or shot fake, things of that nature.
Right idea, just didn't fall. The rebound goes to Bowman. On the fly, Silt Joseph, left hand no. Bond put back yes. Christopher Bond has 6 and Bowman back in front.
That was not a 50-50 ball. That was Bond was there and nobody on Barr-Reeve's going to take it away from him.
Loose ball, Hughes had it, lost it. Bowman's got it. Bond, Madison, basket, yes. Madison, 4 off the bench. It is a 6-0 spurt by Bowman Academy.
Bowman Academy, they see a loose ball, they are on it. And not just the guy who's closest, 3 other guys come to the basketball. Very, very fun team to watch.
Hughes on the bounce to Duncheon. Helms lets fire. Willie Helms, a 46 46% three-point shooter, brings the Barr-Reeve Vikings back within one.
That is a huge shot by a disciplined team.
This is a Barr-Reeve squad that hits 43% from three-point range. Shot up and no good by Joseph Hughes, the rebound, and I think Barr-Reeve's going to hold for one.
Well, it's what we were talking about earlier, Greg. That's not the shot Bowman Academy wants. Now, I know they want to shoot and shoot quickly, but reverse the ball, you get the same shot or better.
See the clock in the lower right-hand corner of your screen. Bowman going to try to come out and again force the tempo for Barr-Reeve, but if there is one area, more so than any other in the state, where they know how to hold for one, it is southwestern Indiana. Lagoni, North Davies, Barr-Reeve, no Forest Park, and a hand-check foul is coming here on Cameron Madison. It'll be his first, team six, so no free throws on this one. Going to be out of bounds with under 7 seconds to go in the quarter.
This was a really good move by Coach Hughes. Earlier in this possession, he set a high ball screen. It brought another defender for Bowman. That time, he went 1-4 flat with his son, Trey Hughes. It's a better move. Trey only has to beat one guy, not two. Got to go north and south here.
Barry's got to go on the quick. Again, you see the clock. Hughes at two, at one, gets it off in time and leaves it short. An exciting first quarter of basketball at Conseco Fieldhouse. It was played at Bowman's pace, but Barr-Reeve's hanging in this one. 12-11, the Eagles are in front. You're watching the Single-A State Championship game on the Indiana Cable Network. As we return to action at Conseco Fieldhouse, Bowman Academy has the basketball and a one-point lead. Dan, your thoughts in the first 8 minutes?
Well, I'm impressed by Bowman Academy's speed. They haven't been able to finish around the rim. For Barr-Reeve, the most impressive thing has been their confidence. They haven't shot well at all. They're sitting here 5-16, but they've gone to the glass, Greg, with 7 offensive rebounds, and they come up with balls like that.
Wagler on the rebound. Ford missed the elbow jumper, and missed shots for Bowman means they really can't set up that full court pressure that they'd like to.
Yeah, they've backed off of that a little bit.
Little dribble weave out top, looking for Wagler for potentially an open three-point shot. And Barr-Reeve has no trouble being patient in the half court. But they'll take a lay-in like that one from Brandon Graber, and Barr-Reeve is back in front.
And it was all set up by Christian Duncheon going north and south. Two things. Barr-Reeve has to shot fake, and when they shot fake, take the ball straight at the rim and find the next. Great job by Duncheon.
Zone from Barr-Reeve. Bowman attacks, and Marrero puts it up and in.
Yeah, that wouldn't hurt to guard him in the middle. He's talented, and he's tough.
So 14-13 is our score. 6:55 left to go in the first half. We've seen Bowman mixing their defenses, both man and zone. That was Barr-Reeve's first possession of zone. Steal by Silk Joseph. Foot race to the other end. Left hand, no. Fight for the loose ball. Madison has it. Step through, no. And still scrambling, Barr-Reeve's got it. And Barr-Reeve's hanging tough with Bowman on the boards. Helms three.
When Helms shoots the ball, you're surprised he missed. There's three kind of shooters. One guy you just don't let shoot. He doesn't shoot. One guy, all right, he's a good enough shooter. And another guy where you're shocked when he misses. Helms is the kind of guy you're shocked if he misses.
Marrero triple teamed. The Barr-Reeve fans wanted the hook, one of the old chicken wing, but Gary Weir says no. It was a foul down low. Let's take a look at the Helms three-point shot.
Again, north and south with penetration, getting the ball into the middle. It completely breaks down Bowman Academy's defense. The kick out to Helms, he's going to make those. You mentioned the hook. Foul was called before the hook. He definitely hooked, but they got the foul before it.
This is Madison on the high right side. Marrero will fire from 15. That does not go. But Madison able to track down the loose ball.
That's not Marrero's game. Marrero's right there, a poster and a driver, not a shooter.
Three, Madison. That's good. Cameron Madison averages 2 a game. The senior off the bench has 7. And Bowman back in front by a point.
Cameron Madison has had a sensational ball game, not only with the 7 that you mentioned, but he's been all over it defensively.
This is Sinnott, sixth man for Barry that had it up top. Wagler turns, misses. Crash by Graber, could not control it. Here comes Bowman on the fly. Ray, drive and steps were taken. 6'6 sophomore, maybe not got to be handling the rock in the middle of the break.
Shouldn't have had the ball. He shouldn't have given him the ball. But that's Bowman. I mean, Bowman's going to take it, and they're going to attack. It doesn't matter who it is.
After a brief break, Christopher Bond will check back in. Silk Joseph will have a seat for Bowman. Bowman has played seven so far today.
It's the biggest lineup that Bowman can put out there with Bond and with Marrero. Be interesting. Here they're going to press, and they're going to use their big guys to guard the basket. Let's see if they turn them over here.
What a luxury for Bowman. You've got the 6'4 Bond playing the point position of that half-court zone trap. Hughes throws it away. Seventh Barr-Reeve turnover. Again, Ray on the bounce, Ray on the drive. I should not have questioned his footwork. He looked good on that one. Missed the shot. Marrero is fouled. And again, we're now seeing the rebounds, Dan, start to even out here.
What Bowman is doing, it was really good down here on the defensive end, Greg. They took the big kid, Ray, and put him under the basket and said, all right, we have the basket covered. Everybody else go pressure. Now, on the other end with the three bigs, just go attack the glass. Throw it up there. Our best offense, if you're Bowman Academy right now, is the missed shot. Go up there, go get it, whether you're Ray, whether you're Marrero, doesn't matter. Go get the ball.
Marrero, a 56% free throw shooter. It's the second of the two. He averages 15 points and 12 rebounds a game. That's right. Bond and Marrero each average 12 boards a night for Bowman. Then again, when you get up 50 shots a game, those things are possible, as you were talking about in the pregame.
Yeah, driving recovery, but you have to be able to finish.
Sinnott the drive, Bond the block shot. That is the fifth block for Bowman. Good body control by Bond to avoid contact. Ray is there for the putback and score.
Throw it up, go get it.
Quite simple, isn't it?
It is for Bowman.
6-point spurt for Bowman. 20-16 is our score. Bowman in front. And Barr-Reeve will take a full timeout. 4:34 left to play in the second quarter. Bowman Academy. It's going to be a game of many runs. They're on one now. They lead by four on the Indiana Cable Network. The Barr-Reeve Vikings, their fans have had a lot to cheer about so far today, a lot to cheer about all season. 24-3, they were 8-0 and undefeated, champions of the Blue Chip Conference. But right now it's Bowman that's going to be on a run. And to make the boxing analogy, Dan, if you're Bryan Hughes, you're going to tell your kids, hey, you're going to take some haymakers today. You got to stand in there and be ready for when things start to turn your way.
Yeah, and it's 12 rounds. Yeah. This isn't going to be a three-round event. This is going to be all day. But one of the things that Barr-Reeve has to do, they've made great moves going to the rim, but they haven't been able to finish. The last shot fake around the rim. They've shot fake on the perimeter. Right here, let's see. Shot, nope.
And it got blocked. You're right. No shot fake, and there's the block. You got to be big on the shot fake and big on reverse layups today.
There's no question. There isn't a big kid alive that won't go for two shot fakes. The first one, maybe he'll stay down. The second one gets him every time.
Ball tipped by Marrero, defending the inbounds pass. Marrero, just a sophomore. Has a lot of college coaches here watching him this morning.
See Bruce Weber here, Billy Taylor from Ball State.
And that's a turnover by Barr-Reeve, and that is turnover number 8 against the Vikings. This team, again, and asking Bryan Hughes earlier this week, is there anything here to simulate what Bowman does in practice? He goes, not even close. is there anybody on your schedule that you've played like Bowman? He goes, not even close. Ray, 3. They're hitting that. Katie barred the door for Bowman Academy.
That was no accident. Ray has a really nice stroke. He looked confident, had a great release.
He has a 47% three-point shooter. Backdoor cut, and Sinnott draws contact. It'll be on the floor. It'll be one plus the bonus on the 7th Bowman Academy team foul. And this one goes against Cameron Madison.
This was set up by Graber. First shot fake, second shot fake by Sinnott. Get into the lane, make a shot, keep shot fake until they jump.
So one plus the bonus. Again, the foul was called before the shot. So Jordan Sinnott, a 6-foot senior, averages 4.5 points and 3.5 rebounds a game. He is a 69% free throw shooter on the season. First free throw of the day for Barr-Reeve is good. And that ends a 9-0 Bowman blitz. He makes them both. Barr-Reeve as a team, a 75% free throw shooting team. Marrero turns, spins, leaves that one short. Graver is there for the rebound. Hughes is trying to pick his way through the battlefield at this point. And a reach-in foul coming here. Looks like it gets Kevon Ford. It'll be one plus the bonus again for the Vikings.
This is where Hughes' patience paid off. He was in real trouble, and he was able to find the next guy. What they have to do, Greg, before they get to half court, they've got to throw it up the floor. If you're going to dribble it past half court, you're in real trouble against Barr-Reeve.
You're saying north and south and not east and west, I believe?
Always north and south. If you go east and west, they get hands. One of the things about Bowman, you know, they're athletic and they're quick, all that kind of stuff. But boy, they have active hands. I mean, they are tracing the basketball. They're very well coached in their trap.
Get a good look at Floyd Hoskins, who just checked in. And I had to mention this at some point in time. Rocking the high top fade, Silk Joseph. That's what you expect a kid of the name of Silk. That's the haircut he should be wearing right there. Dan and I could not grow that thing if we tried for years. Ball out of bounds off the hands of Brandon Graber. It'll be Bowman basketball.
You know, back in the day, you didn't show any ear. Never could go with a high top fade. Maybe now I do. I cut it close to keep the top looking a little
All I know in this day is I show a lot from the back. That's all I can tell you. So for the basketball, Barry back to a man-to-man. This is Hoskins, his first touch of the morning. Hoskins averages a point and a half a game. Ray lets fire from 17. That's no good, but there's Bond, and that's an easy bucket. And that is where Bowman lives, Dan.
It is, and Bond is very good at that. He anticipated the miss. I think he knew that Ray couldn't make that shot. Anticipated, got great offensive rebound position.
This is Wagler sees three white shirts in his vicinity. Now Hughes on the push, had it stripped, but it goes right to Graber. Graber's pump fake that time brought the defense to it. Now Bond on the run. Bond around, over, no good. Fight for the loose ball. It's going to be a jump ball. And the arrow will give possession to the Barr-Reeve Vikings.
And Hughes went north and south, got a pretty good shot, but you have to finish. Here, Bond, pretty good defense, getting your head on the bucket, not letting him get a layup, but there's a 50-50 ball. Those are the basketballs. Helms had to come up with that ball.
And Helms, again, future Marine, this kid's a tough kid, but he has to hobble to the sidelines. Believe he bumped knees with a Bowman player. So Helms is on the bench, and there you see him going to go try to stretch it out. So we see Josh Swartzentruber, a 5'10 senior, check in for the first time for the Barr-Reeve Vikings. Ball's going to get across half court. It does. Duncheon right by Ray and draws the foul. Elijah Ray picks up the foul, his first, and Christian Duncheon will shoot two free throws.
You break the press, you go right at Bowman. And then there was a little bit of a stutter fake there. Pretty good move by Duncheon. But once you break it, this is what Coach Hughes was saying before the game, you mentioned it. Once you break it, you have to be judicious, but you have to go at the rim, get some easy points.
Duncheon hits the free throw. He is a 76% free throw shooter. You can look at Bryan Hughes. Of course, I've got to mention this, being an alum myself, a graduate of the University of Indianapolis from back in 1982.
The Harvard of the Midwest.
Well, at least the Harvard of the South Side, at least that far. Marrero will check back in, replacing Elijah Ray. Duncheon's older brother Nick plays basketball at the University of Southern Indiana. Duncheon makes both. He's got four, and Barr-Reeve back within five. Joseph, beautiful spin, left hand bump, couldn't get the shot. It was pretty all the way to the basket, and he will shoot two free throws.
Joseph really stayed low here. Look how low he is in his spin. Enables him to explode. Now, he took contact. Probably feels like he should have finished that. But here's another guy coming in off the bench that's getting something done.
And Joseph, a 63% free throw shooter, and misses that one.
When he shot that one, it was like he was backing up from the moment he released it.
No need to be in a hurry. You got one more coming.
Just hang in there, lean forward, make it, set up your press.
Marvin Rea barking out orders, and in fact, he wants a timeout before the free throw. So Marvin Rea asks for time, and he'll get it here. It'll be a 30-second timeout. If you're Marvin Rea, what do you discuss with your kids in this break here, Dan?
What I just said. Make this free throw. Let's set up our press. He's going to talk to them about covering the middle. Because if Barr-Reeve can get the basketball into the middle, and it's been wide open against this trap, either the middle or diagonal. I was watching him last time down when Barr-Reeve scored. He was upset with one of his players for not covering the middle. Pressure, but keep the ball out of the middle. Keep it on the side is what he's going to talk about right now.
So one more free throw coming up for Silk Joseph, the senior. Averaging 9 points and 2 rebounds a basketball game. Bowman Academy, Thea Bowman Academy, if we use the proper and full name. Charter school in Gary, an enrollment of 420. They are not affiliated with a conference, and sadly, they do not play the other three Gary public schools. So Gary Wallace is here in the 3A game, and those two schools are, what, about a mile and a half, 2 miles apart. They do not play each other.
Yeah, they're not very far, but I'll say this. Bowman Academy will play anybody. I mean, they went and played Peoria, Emanuel, Bentonville, Iowa. They're not afraid to play anybody.
Hoskins put that one down to avoid the travel, and Bond tracks it down. And Joseph took an extra step and traveled with the basketball.
That's a mistake Marvin Rea can live with. You know, and watching him interact with his team, he's okay with everything that's aggressive. If you're passive, I'm guessing you're sitting at the end of the bench.
No passive here. Steal by Bond. Finger roll by Bond is up and going. That's the 10th Barr-Reeve turnover.
Somebody has to get in the middle for Barr-Reeve and come back to the basketball.
A blocking foul on Kevon Ford will be his second. It'll be free throws for Trey Hughes. Double bonus coming up for Barr-Reeve.
Here's the last bucket by Bond. And Bond is a terrific finisher. But Greg, after that foul, it was exactly what we said at the timeout. Coach Rea was telling his team, don't foul. So as soon as the foul happened down here, he immediately turned, marched to the end of the bench so whatever he said wouldn't be overheard by anybody but himself, grabbed himself some water, and now he's working the refs.
I believe that's referred to as crisis management in the coaching business.
It's called being smart. Sometimes, even though there's a bunch of people here and you're in a big gym, it's not bad to be alone with your thoughts.
Jordan Sinnott will check back in for Barr-Reeve, replacing Brandon Graber. Great crowd here on hand for the morning session. It'll only get bigger as the fans from Wheeler and Park Tudor begin arriving over the next hour. And Hughes, a 77% free throw shooter, makes them both. Barr-Reeve, a perfect 6 of 6 on the line. That's keeping me in this contest. It's a 5-point Bowman lead as we approach the 2-minute mark. And a reach-in foul on Helms. And fouls now starting to add up on Barr-Reeve as well. Two each now on Duncheon, Graber, and Helms, and two free throws coming up for Joseph.
Well, Joseph's really aggressive. You can tell he wants to get into the lane. This game feels a 5-point game. But this has a feel to me like Bowman's up about 12.
Yeah. Part of the reason is Bowman has not been making as many of their free throws. And, of course, on cue, Joseph hits that. The free throw line so far. Bowman Academy. Now 6 of 9. So Helms will get a breather again, playing with two fouls. As Schwarzentruber checks back in. Joseph leaves that one short. Tipped by Hoskins. Bond couldn't track it down, and Schwarzentruber grabs the loose ball for Barr-Reeve.
In the middle of the zone.
Just floated that one out of the reach of Joseph.
You do that again, Bowman's going the other way.
And a blocking foul coming here on Hoskins. And yet again, Barr-Reeve's going to go back to the free throw line. And if you're Bowman, for no other reason, forget foul trouble adding up for you. You're giving a team that's having a hard time finding an open shot, you're giving them two free looks every trip down.
And that's exactly what Coach Rea talked about at that last timeout. Make them score. Don't give them points. Make them score. It's frustrating for a coach when your team keeps fouling, putting a team that maybe can't score on the foul line.
So Hughes now with 7. Helms leads the Barr-Reeve attack with 8. You look at Trey. Candidate for the All-Star team this year from Barr-Reeve High School. 17 and a half points, 5 assists, and 3 rebounds a game. Back to a 4-point game. Joseph stepped back from 16, will not get the roll, but weak side presence, 4, no, tip in, yes.
Well, Trey Hughes right there, stop playing. Bowman will not stop playing. Trey Hughes thought the first shot was going in, and then he stopped playing. His dad would absolutely get on him about that at halftime.
Barr-Reeve will back it out. We approach the 1-minute mark. Left to go here in the half. all alone is Schwartzentruber. Good screen by Sinnott to make sure he was open. And Schwartzentruber gets his first bucket off the bench.
And a terrific look by Trey Hughes. Maybe his dad won't be so mad at him at halftime.
Marrero turns, nice feed to Bond, who will lay it up and in great post-to-post pass. So Bond now with a dozen. And Doc, you ready to go talk to a coach on the sidelines here? Steal by Bowman, tip in by Bond. They're going to wave it off and say it was over the rim. They do. So wave off the basket. We'll be able to take a look for ourselves and see. Ford shot, no. Bond, 50-50 call. 32-26 remains our score. Hughes again kind of picking his way up the floor. Scoop shot, no. Marrero with the rebound. Joseph, drive and dish, three in the corner. That is short. Marrero, fight for the loose ball. Step through, left hand and score. DeJuan Marrero with five. It's an 8-point game for Bowman Academy. Hughes into the front court. Steal by Bowman. Bond, look ahead, pass forward. Four, right hand, scoop and score. Bowman on the attack. 3 seconds left to go in the half. It's a 10-point lead. Schwartzentruber from 40. It does not go. Bowman yet another run at the end of the half. 36-26. Bowman in front. Dan Dockich is standing by with Bowman Academy head coach Marvin Rea. Marvin Rea, Dan, go ahead.
Well, we're here with Coach Marvin Rea. Marvin, that was the run you wanted at the end of the half.
Yes, we've been trying to set up that run the whole first half. As you can see, we had some of our stars in foul trouble. We're able to sneak some of our key players in at the end and apply some good defense, apply the full court press. That was definitely what we were looking for. Kind of get a little room here. You know how it works.
What you'll tell your team, I'm guessing, is keep pressuring but quit fouling.
Keep pressuring, you know, stop fouling. The key, like I told them, by the fourth quarter, we got our benches deep. Those guys on the other side, they have to be tired. I mean, they have to be tired when we get to the fourth quarter, guys on the other side. I don't care about the score right now. I don't care about the foul situation. I need the fourth quarter where, hey, it's five against five, and the guys that put the work in the gym, 2, 3, 4 hours of running, it's going to win the game.
I'll let you go. Good luck to you. Back to you, Greg.
Thank you very much, Dan. Again, Marvin Rea happy with the way his team has finished this first half. Barr-Reeve and Bowman been trading blows all half long. The Eagles landed the last one. They lead by 10 at the break. Here on the Indiana Cable Network. As we return to Conseco Fieldhouse, Greg Rexdraw from Hometown Sports Indiana, Dan Dockich from 107 of the Fan with you here on the Indiana Cable Network. Bowman Academy, again, as we said, landed the last haymaker of the half. Couple of steals, couple of easy buckets. They lead by 10, 36-26. And let's revisit our keys to the game that were brought to us by the Shelbourne Knee Center. Has Barr-Reeve done these two things, Dan?
Well, I thought they did early, and the 50-50 balls aren't only layups, but they're balls out on the floor when you're being trapped. I don't think they've done a good job late in the half of making Bowman beat you with the first shot. Bowman can't beat Barr-Reeve with the first shot, but they can with 13 offensive rebounds in the first half.
Now the keys for the Bowman Academy Eagles. Again, Bowman played their proper game of basketball, at least the way they like to play, late in that second quarter.
Yeah, they did. They did establish a fast pace early, then went away from it, and then got it going late. Get to 50, that means 50 shots in the game. Well, right now, at halftime, they have 36 shots, so they're well on their way to doing that.
So again, Bowman Academy playing their style of basketball late. If you're Barr-Reeve, they attack the pressure at first, but as this has gone along, again, they've kind of been retreating a little bit in that half-court offense, and I'm not sure that's what Bryan Hughes wants his kids to do.
Well, what they need to do is give the ball up earlier. There have been openings either up the floor, against the press, same side, or diagonal. Now, it's easy for me to sit here and say that's what you should do. It's more difficult to see it against the long, active arms of Bowman Academy, but Bryan Hughes wants the ball up the floor a little bit quicker. Don't pick it up at half court.
Again, the first of four games today here at Conseco Fieldhouse. You guys should be a little more excited. His team's playing well and up by 10. It's a single-A state championship game on the Indiana Cable Network. As we return to Conseco Fieldhouse, time now for the Shelbourne Knee Center Halftime Report with Bowman Academy enjoying a 36-26 lead. We'll start with showing you of our first half highlights. And again, Bowman to the basket. That's a key at any time of the game for Bowman Academy.
Well, it is. And the kid you saw in the first highlight, Christopher Bond, has been sensational with 12 points and 6 rebounds. Trey Hughes, we talked about going north and south. You have to attack the rim against Bowman Academy. You can't go east and west.
Bowman on putbacks. Barr-Reeve slowed that down the first quarter. Bowman got more of them in the second quarter. And how about the play of Cameron Madison off the bench with 7?
I thought Cameron Madison was a big key, not only with 7 points, but his activity, his aggressiveness on the defensive end. Bowman Academy, here you see it, 13 offensive rebounds in the first half. That's far too many for Barr-Reeve to overcome.
Bond had 12 and 6 for Barr-Reeve. There you see the shooting stats. And again, neither team shooting well. Bowman dramatically improved as the half went along. Free throws, very good for Barr-Reeve, not bad for Bowman. Rebounds, only a 3-rebound lead for Bowman, but it was a 7-board advantage in the second quarter.
Yeah, it was. Early in the game, Barr-Reeve did a nice job, particularly on their own offensive end. But as we see in these stats, it caught up to them, the athletic ability of Bowman Academy, 24-10 points in the paint. If I would make a guess, I would say of those 24 points, 20 of them either came off steals and layups or second shots, as opposed to running offense, getting in the lane, throwing it down to the block.
It'll be Bowman basketball when we come back to begin quarter number 3. You're watching the 1A state championship game on the Indiana Cable Network. Third quarter getting ready to start here at Conseco Fieldhouse. Again, the first of 4 today at Conseco. And if that wasn't enough, how about the 100th anniversary parade of champions that will take place in between sessions today throughout downtown and ending here at Conseco Fieldhouse as well. All in all, a celebration of 100 years of Indiana high school basketball taking place today here at Conseco Fieldhouse. Again, Greg Rakestraw and Dan Dockich with you on the Indiana Cable Network. It'll be Bowman Academy basketball to begin quarter number 3. And as we see the Barr-Reeve Vikings come back onto the floor, Dan, what must Barr-Reeve do? I won't say to get back in this basketball, they're only down by 10, but to get momentum back on their side.
Well, you need stops, and stops mean defensive backboard. Defensive backboard is huge in this game. I'm not so sure after watching them for half how well Bowman Academy shoots the basketball, but I know how well they get to the backboard.
So Marrero on the touch, drives left hand, kind of fires it up there and got that one to go.
Kind of flipped that one in there, kind of from his hip. It was an old school shot.
38-26.
Right now, diagonal. There it is. And you go.
Helms thought about the open 3. He hit 2 in the first half. Duncheon turns, finds no room at the end, and eventually loses the basketball.
Greg, that's what I've been saying. Not only do they pressure, not only do they trap, but their hands are so active.
Marrero steps through, left-handed scoring. I think Marrero found the range at halftime.
Yeah, and I think his coach lit him up a little bit, probably, and told him he needed to be more aggressive on the offensive end.
The 14-point lead, the largest of the game for Bowman Academy. And Bowman now on an 8-0 run. Nice, looked away by Hughes, finds Graver for an open layup.
Boy, that was tremendous. That was absolutely tremendous. Hughes split the defense, found with a bounce pass.
Pull up 3, no good by Moore. Bond saves it to nobody in particular. Out of bounds to Barr-Reeve. And again, Bowman's hit a couple of threes, but that really, they don't need to settle for threes. They can get shots at the basket like Barr-Reeve did on this trip.
Yeah, and Hughes, as we said, split the defense. It was funny after that shot. Coach Ray just kind of looked and said, what are you doing? He couldn't get mad. He just started smiling and laughing.
You can do that with a 12-point
lead. Yes, you can.
Wagler thought 3, now draws the trap. Kick it back out to Hugh. And Bowman started off in a zone trap in the first half, kind of switched to man and went back and forth. Helms 3, that is no good off the backboard. Fighting the loose ball, and Bond is grabbing everything in his area this afternoon. Tyrae Robinson from 16. That's a jump shot you can live with. That's a good take by the lefty.
Absolutely. You get the ball down the floor, you move it around a little bit, and that was bad defense by Barr-Reeve. That's the first time we've seen Barr-Reeve really not get the guys.
Helms on the wing. We'll skip it to Wagler for 3. Duncheon has inside position. Lost it, turned, and a hold called on the floor. It'll be out of bounds to the Vikings.
I really like this Duncheon kid. He's kind of the only option inside for Barr-Reeve. He's willing. He's tough. He'll battle. You see him battle Bond there. You know, there's no backup in him. He's taking the ball at the rim. I really like that kid.
The toughest he's seeing from Bowman Academy. That was pickup games in the backyard against your brother. Yeah. When your brother's a scholarship basketball player and 3 inches taller, that's a good training ground for games like this one. And Hughes is trying to find an opening, fires from 17 and rattles it in. Just the third field goal for Hughes. He's got 10 to pace the Vikings. They hang around down by 12. Marrero. And Marrero again has found the rhythm.
It's a shot Barr-Reeve can live with, though. And you're right, Marrero has found the rhythm. Marrero actually walked down the court, looked like he'd been shooting jump shots his whole life.
Duncheon pass tipped away, but Graber there to track it down. And a foul called on the floor on DeJuan Marrero.
Again, it's the hands. You know, we talk about the quickness. We talk about the tempo. We talk about how hard Bowman plays. But it's the hands of Bowman. Here's Hughes. Now, this is the third straight possession, Greg. They've come down, shot a jump shot. They have to make shots. You know, you do a lot of analysis, what's going to work, what's not. A lot of times,
big shots.
Down to make shots. That's it.
We're just filling airtime other than making shots.
No doubt.
Foul will go against Tyrae Robinson. See the bump here on the inbounds pass.
Again, a play Coach Ray can live with. Be aggressive, and he'll live with that. That's three on Tyrae Robinson. He's got to come out.
Kevon Ford, who had 4 points in the first half. Again, 5'10 senior. Bowman Academy, their top seven players. 5 seniors, 2 sophomores. Floater, nicely done by Ashton Wagler. Good looking shot for his first basket of the day. Wagler averages 9 a contest, the third leading Barr-Reeve scorer. Moore on the board. Nick Moore didn't play much in the first half. That's his first field goal. One thing that Barr-Reeve can't do, they're starting to get a rhythm offensively, but they really can't trade baskets at this point with Bowman. Hughes has got to hurry. Does beat the 10-second strike. All the way in. Didn't have a good angle. Outlet pass Marrero. To Moore. To the basket. Timeout Barr-Reeve.
Where Wagler made a mistake right there, number 40. Hughes goes to the rim, fine. You want to take a chance, you're your best player, go to the rim. But it was on Wagler to get back to his head on the rim because you know Bowman's going to go.
It'll be a 30-second timeout taken by Barr-Reeve. They still have 3 remaining. Bowman has 4 at their disposal. And take a look at the heads-up play on the outlet by Marrero.
Well, that's what I was saying. Wagler's number 40, and he's not going to be able to catch up to Bowman Academy. He has to be there initially. He didn't rotate back, and it's those little things that the athleticism of Bowman Academy gets you. A little tip ball, offensive rebound, things like that. Not getting back on defense. Hands involved, getting a steal, getting it down the other
end. You look at Marrero again. 5 in the first half, but 6 here in the second half. Marrero now 11. He averages 14 and a half a game. Coming into tonight's game, Bond, Robinson, and Marrero each average 14 points or better on the season. It has not been a big day for Robinson. He is currently sitting with 3 fouls.
Score 85 a night.
You're going to have a lot of guys get points on the board. 5-second violation. Wagler couldn't get it in. And I think that time Wagler was kind of intimidated by the aura of the Bowman pressure more than anything else.
He had some guys open.
Moore lost it. One thing Bowman has done quite well today is take care of the basketball. That is just their 6th turnover.
You know, Barr-Reeve can get right back in this basketball game. They're going to get good looks. Either by, if they handle the ball. Now, you got to handle the ball. But out of this, if they get the ball reversed, they'll get a good look, but you have to go ahead and make it.
Hughes will fire.
That was not a good look. One more pass would have been a good look.
Wagler's there, though, for the putback. Ashton Wagler with 4. Bowman, a little casual the basketball and turns it over.
Yeah, Coach Ray's not having it. He's going to put Madison in, again, a kid that was key in the first half. He'll take aggressive, but he won't take sloppy.
You saw Coach Ray just kind of point to the temples and say, think, fellas. And here's Wagler going up with it quickly, trying to beat the Bowman defense with the shot attempt.
Throw it ahead. There you go.
Duncheon saves and throws it away.
There's our guy again.
Madison just checked back in, got a steal. Now has an open look. That one a little short. We got 2 3-point lines today on this court. He shot that one behind the college 3-point line. timeout going to be called by Barr-Reeve. Let's see if it'll be the 30 or the full, and Hughes comes up a little bit gimpy.
There are some guys you worry about coming up gimpy and going out. Nobody on Barr-Reeve. They're really tough kids.
Full timeout taken by Bryan Hughes. Will step aside as well. His Vikings trail by 14 here on the Indiana Cable Network. 34. Bowman Academy is in front by 14. Slowly they're starting to expand this lead. What must Barr-Reeve do to hang around in this one?
Well, handle the ball and block out, but slow down Bowman Academy. They're 6-for-8 from the field.
Duncheon will bring it across the half-court stripe, and here comes the back pressure from Madison. It'll be a jump ball. It'll be out of bounds to Barr-Reeve on the arrow. Duncheon hoping for a foul call. Did not get it.
Well, he took the ball in a bad spot. Again, you have to throw the ball either diagonal up the floor, middle up the floor, or same side up the floor, not dribble it right there.
Hughes again facing pressure from three Bowman players and a reach-in foul. It'll be coming here from Cameron Madison. That'll be his third foul.
If you're going to play with the basketball in that area of the floor against Bowman Academy, the only way you're going to get bailed out is with a foul, because they're going to take it from you, knock it off you, do something.
For Bowman Academy, Kendall Dawson will check in for the first time. And Madison will have a seat. So again, Madison with three, Robinson with three. And so Marvin Rea's got a little deeper into his bench, bringing Dawson in for the first time. Bowman makes you play at their tempo. They make you attack the basket. And on that one, Duncheon draws the foul. And he'll shoot two.
They broke the press by throwing it up the floor. And then Duncheon, who I said earlier, I just really enjoy watching him play. He's a tough kid. You can beat Bowman Academy one-on-one with the dribble, but you have to get the ball down the floor to get it in a position to only take one or two dribbles and get to the rim.
It's the fact that Duncheon is the valedictorian of his senior class at Barr-Reeve, an enrollment of 185 at Barr-Reeve High School.
8,000 people here from Barr-Reeve.
And every alum in a three-state radius. And there's a lot of folks here that are going to wear Barr-Reeve colors and watch the first game. And then they'll change the black and white or black and red to black and gold for the Hatchets in the first game of the evening session. And they got the group discount on the travel package up here.
I don't know if there's many people from Lagodi or North Davies in the field.
No, no. Big rivals of Barr-Reeve. Barr-Reeve beat both those two squads in the section. In fact, they beat Lagodi, who was also ranked in the opener. Drive the basket by Madison to check back in. That's an offensive foul, and for Madison, that is foul number four. So he brought him back in, and his return was brief.
Now you see the charge here, but it was set up by a nice adjustment. Really nice adjustment by Coach Hughes when Marrero got the ball. Remember, he's hit three buckets in this half. They went and post-doubled him. They're not going to let Marrero get to the rim or make shots. Really nice adjustment post-doubling out of Coach Hughes.
The Moore will check in.
Throw it up the floor.
Wagner will find Graver. Mari back within 12. Hughes, nice reverse dribble floater, couldn't get it to go. And Moore will track down the loose ball. Marrero drives, floater, got it.
Well, he shoots that ball, he kind of pops it out of his hand with no spin. But boy, is it soft. I don't want to sound like I'm rooting for Barr-Reeve when I say throw it up the floor. I think I'm just coaching.
Hard to erase 20 plus years of habits, isn't it?
It is.
Foul going to be called on the block, on the first attempt at the block. And that's on Bond, and that is now his third. So Bond has picked up three here in this quarter. Brandon Graber will shoot two.
Bond got a foul there, but boy, was he impressive. He was out of the play. And like the kids from Bowman do, he hustled, he sprinted, and got back into play. Unfortunately for him, it was a foul.
Graber picks up or misses the free throw. He is a 71% shooter. Barr-Reeve 10 of 12 from the line today. The foul's starting to add up for Bowman. Graber now with five. He averages six a game. see Elijah Ray at the scorer's table for both. Moore, the drive off the backboard, no. Marrero put back, no. Bond put back, yes.
That's what they do. They don't beat you with the first shot, they beat you with the second or the third.
That was the third. Raver. Wagler will fire over Marrero and get it to go. Tough shot by Ashton Wagler. Marrero squares, spins, fades, and misses that one. Bond now jumps a man, draws a foul, can't get the shot to go, and he'll have two.
Christian Bond, Greg, is a really impressive player. I mean, he hustles. He has tremendous hands. He has tremendous timing.
Here's a look at Helms.
You'll see Bond here. Great hand right there. Jumps up over. Great timing getting the ball at its apex. Should have finished that. I'm sure he'll tell you that. But he's a very impressive player with a great looking free throw stroke.
So Bond now with 15. Ray will come in. And again, he will get the shooters. He's got to wait.
He came in for just anybody.
He's wanting to get the game, man.
Came in, said, Moore, get out. Who am I supposed to get for?
Why would you not want some run at Conseco Fieldhouse? And Bond, of course, on cue, misses the free throw. Stay in the game that way. 53-39. Full court pressure again applied by Bowman Academy. Hughes, an open three. That does not go, but Wagler, the weak side board. He'll fire from 17. That does not go, and Marrero scrambles out of there with a rebound. Great look ahead from Moore. Extra pass, Bond, and an overpass that time by Bowman. Bond thought that Ford was going to the basket.
In transition defense, Barr-Reeve got lucky. Nobody came back, put their head under the rim. Here you go, out in transition, throwing the basketball ahead. Nobody is in the yellow area underneath the basket. Rule of thumb, first thing you have to do, first guy back, put your head under the basket.
So Ray in, Bond sits with three fouls. Duncheon picks up that dribble in a bad place, tipped by Marrero. Extra pass, Moore. Moore takes the body, misses. Marrero tip one, no. Marrero tip two, yes. I believe you said the third shot beat you.
Not the first.
Marrero with 15, 10 in this quarter. 55-39, Bowman matches their largest lead. Sinek sent backwards by Ray. Again, misses. Gets it again. This one, no. And Marrero the rebound. For the drive, takes the bump, takes the second bump, draws the foul. And the Bowman fans on their feet sensing they might be putting this one away.
They have seen this before. Coach Ray said it at halftime, we're going to try to wear you out. There's two, there's three, there's a bucket. They don't beat you with shot number one.
Even Ford will go to the free throw line after drawing the foul on this one. Ford, a 29% free throw shooter. Normally with a 29% shooter, there's some sort of ugly hitch. He really didn't have it there, even though he missed the first one. Didn't exactly have bad form.
Yeah, I disagree with you. That was not a thing of beauty.
Okay.
Let's see. Now that was good there.
See?
Really good. He was a 34% three-point shooter.
Go ahead and back up then. All
like
metal.
Will Chamberlain used to, remember?
Yep.
Used to back up, go to the side.
So two misses by Bowman. See if Barr-Reeve will hold for one. The answer is no. Wagler three, no. But Duncheon is there. Put back, yes. Steal by Trey Hughes, but couldn't hang on to it. See if Bowman will hold for a final shot.
I'm guessing that.
You were correct. Ford misses, but they was tipped out of bounds off a Bowman player. It'll be Barr-Reeve basketball. Take a look here.
Keyvon Ford shoots this shot. Coach Ray very unhappy, not understanding score, time. You know, I know Bowman wants to play fast, and obviously nobody wants to play faster than Coach Ray, but you do have to understand where you're at in the ball game.
Helms into the front court. Hughes pressure. Can get up a final shot. Pass is tipped, taken away. Marrero on the run. Won't get it off in time. He got the dunk, but clearly after the horn and the whistle. So he got the flush, but won't get the points. Bowman will take a 14-point lead into the fourth quarter. It still looks pretty on replay.
And the fans love it.
On the Indiana Cable Network. 55-41, Bowman Academy in front. It was 10 at halftime. As many as 16, it is now 14. What must Bowman do, Dan, to put this away as we take a look at our stats after three?
Well, Coach Marvin Rea said at halftime, the fourth quarter is what they want to get to. They want to wear Barr-Reeve down. I think Barr-Reeve's kids are too tough to get down. Barr-Reeve's going to come, and they're going to be aggressive. You see it here, points in the paint. Second half, they went to Marrero, Bowman did early. I think they'll continue that and play out.
One of the things on that stat graphic that I saw that is a little disconcerting for Barr-Reeve, and they probably felt they had to do better at this today, is shoot from three-point range. They're just 2 of 10 from behind the arc.
And of those 10, I'm going to say 8 have been really good looks.
Robinson, hesitation dribble, goes all the way in, misses the jump shot. Wagler wins the jumping battle down low, but Marrero able to tip it away, tank it away. Robinson drives and draws the foul. That is now 16 Barr-Reeve turnovers.
And of those 16 turnovers, I'm going to say probably 12 have been because of active hands. You know, people talk about athletic ability, they quickness, jumping, all those kind of things. Not really. I mean, that's a part of it, but the ability to have active hands with anticipation is enormous, and Bowman's as good as you're going to see.
Robinson on the season, a 73% free throw shooter. Just 5 points today for Robinson. And of their big three, he's had kind of the most quiet game, but he's done a good job of running this offense and forcing the tempo. Missed free throw, but we'll say another steal by Bowman. And here comes the full court pressure by the Eagles. Hughes slipped on the logo at center court. Turns it over. Moore, the drive and the lead for Marrero. Marrero's shot does not go. You referenced spin on his shots earlier. That one is like a knuckleball.
That's all he shoots. He shoots a little pop shot.
Duncheon spins, steps through, lets Marrero fly by and scores.
Great patience by Duncheon right there.
He waited for Marrero to make his move. 12 steals today for Bowman Academy. Barr-Reeve tried to get their third, but Helms could not control. Out of bounds to Bowman. Moore will trigger an inbounds for Bowman Academy. Last year, in their first year of eligibility for the state tournament, knocked out in the regional round by Triton. Went on to be the runner-up in the state last year to Jackson Dell. A drive and a foul. The foul on Trey Hughes.
Well, really quick. This kid, Joseph, he's 0 for 6. He's 1 for 4 from the foul line. But I think he's had a huge impact on this basketball game. When he came in and started being aggressive in the second quarter, I thought it kind of energized Bowman Academy.
Silk, a senior, gets that free throw to go.
I have no idea. Now, you talk about good-looking strokes. He has a tremendous stroke. His wrist and his follow through is exceptional. He should never be one. Ever. Right, now he's not. 3 for 6.
Law of averages catching up. 58-43. And the lead has kind of went back and forth between about 10 and 15 almost this entire half. Moore the steal, Moore the foul, and the basket. Bowman now again starting to extend here in the fourth quarter.
Too much athletic ability and too much dribbling. Nobody has uncovered themselves for Barr-Reeve. And when you dribble against Bowman Academy, and frankly, it's over because they're quick, they're low, they move their feet, and they have, as I keep saying and pounding at home, incredibly active hands.
More
it's a fun team to watch, Greg.
71% free throw shooter. See Ashton Wagler. Near full from head coach Bryan Hughes in the Barr-Reeve sideline. Moore, good looking free throw stroke there. He's got 7 limited minutes today. So an 18-point lead, the largest of the morning. Now Barr-Reeve beats the pressure down the floor. Graber, hesitation, drive and score. Brandon Graber with 7. And now Barr-Reeve has no choice. They've got to attack. Down by 16 with 6.5 minutes to play.
Be interested to see what Bowman does here. How much they'll hold on to the basket. What's your guess?
Not very.
Well, they are holding it here.
Robinson will pull up from 15 and get the roll.
Now you can clearly see that that's Robinson's spot. That's a second basket he's made. 1-2 dribbles, elbow jump shot. Nobody's moving right now. Nobody's moving for Barr-Reeve.
Finds Helms. Helms takes the bump, finds Duncheon. Give and go to Duncheon. Extra pass, Sinnott. And stripped away by Moore.
What I mean by not moving, it's a little bit like football, where a wide receiver or a quarterback is scrambling. You can't stand as a wide receiver. You have to move, uncover yourself, come back to the ball. Barr-Reeve, too much standing down the floor.
Duncheon will trigger it out top to Hughes. Bowman will extend that zone trap. They find Sinnott all alone. Marrero sends that one backwards. Stripped was greater, and Bond gets the takeaway.
That was great closing speed by Marrero to block that shot.
Bond, no. Hughes on the run. Hughes weaving his way in traffic. Went to the left hand, couldn't get it to go, and Robinson snared it, and now showtime. Marrero. Left hand, just calmly and collectively laid it up and in.
And again, Graber didn't rotate back. Hughes went to the rim. I promise you, Coach Hughes worked on that. When somebody goes to the rim, get back immediately. They haven't done a very good job, Barr-Reeve hasn't, in this ball.
Graber all alone, catch and shoot, no. Sinnott is fouled by Joseph on the putback. So Jordan Sinnott will shoot two. Even Ford will check in for Bowman Academy after the first free throw.
Well, I think Coach Ray's halftime analysis is pretty good.
Yeah, we're going to beat you in the fourth quarter.
Yep, just wear you out, wear you out, wear you out, and go get you.
Jordan Sinnott missed that free throw. But for every free throw made today, Taco Bell will donate $10 up to $500 to the IHSAA Centennial Scholarship Award.
You know what Coach Ray's done a great job of? He has engaged all his players. You know, when you play a lot of guys and you're in the state finals, everybody wants to play, everybody wants to get theirs. Not this team. He told me that this week. He said this team has no ego. They just want to play, they want to win, and they want to have fun, and they've sure done that today.
Sinnott hits the free throw, and Barr-Reeve will take a full timeout. A little trivia note about Marvin Ray when we come back. You're watching the 1A State Championship game on the Indiana Cable Network. See some of the Bowman fans getting their cameras ready. We mentioned their little trivia about Marvin Rea, as Bowman leads by 19 with 5-10 and counting left to play. If this score remains the way it is, he'd become the second coach slash player in high school history to win the Mental Attitude Award as a player, as Robinson hits the baseline jumper, and to do it as a coach. He would join Jim Myers, who also accomplished that feat as a player and coach at Bossy High School in 39 and 1962. 67-46, Duncheon on the drive, draws the foul of Marrero, and he will shoot two.
You just get the sense that you can never get in a rhythm against Bowman Academy. Everything's choppy. Everything is contested. They just take you out of what you want to do. Now, earlier in the game, I think Barr-Reeve had a real shot. If they could have knocked in some of those open threes, might have been a different ballgame.
Dunson's free throw is good. He has 11. Bowman's one loss this season was to 3A Culver Academy, 59-56 on February the 11th.
They haven't shied away from anybody. I mean, you look at the schools they've played, Indianapolis, Howe, Peoria, Manual, Covington, Holmes, a great program in Kentucky, Chicago, Bogut, Indianapolis, Broad Ripple, Bishop Lures with Deshaun Thomas.
Beat Lures and Deshaun Thomas. Helms got his hands on it, couldn't control it. Robinson fires from three. That is an air ball. Nice pass by Hughes to Duncheon. Again, waits for the contact, gets the foul from Marrero, and Duncheon will shoot two. Dan Bowman has played teams from five different states this year.
You have to credit Marvin Ray. I mean, you really do. He knows what he has. He knows some teams won't play him. So he goes and he finds the best competition. You mentioned five states, a couple from Kentucky, a couple from Illinois, Bettendorf, Iowa, Michigan, Covert from Michigan. And he's also taken on some traditionally great programs in the state of Indiana. South Bend, Washington, a great program. Indianapolis High with a couple Division I kids in their program.
Beat Basil Bobby's Barber team by 17 in Indianapolis. That was a neutral site game played at Howell before Christmas.
Well, how about East Chicago Central?
Yeah.
I mean, East Chicago Central is as good as it gets in the region.
Robinson now content to dribble the basketball and force Barr-Reeve to come get him. Five count is not being applied. And here comes a little trap here by Barr-Reeve. They've got to come out of it and try to force Bowman into some quicker shots. As the Eagles are going to try to play keep away here. The Bowman fans come to their feet to make a little noise. Their team leading by 17, less than four to play. Joseph on the drive, goes all the way in, draws the foul. And again, that's what you want if you're Bowman. Once you get past two or three guys, then go to the basket and shoot layups.
And we always think, and we've watched it here, that Bowman Academy is fast break, let's go team. But you also have to be able to handle game situations. Slow down is a game situation. And they handle it very, very well.
Foul is on Graber, his third. And Silk Joseph will miss the free throw. Moore and Bond will check back in. Michael Ford had checked in momentarily for Bowman. He checks out. All 12 players have played today for Bowman Academy. Joseph makes that one. He's now 4 of 8 from the line today. All his points coming from the stripe. And Bowman will not back off this full court pressure. No reason to, and especially it takes time off the clock from Barr-Reeve. Graber on the drive. Didn't have an angle to attack. Now we'll back it out to Helms. Poked away from Duncheon, able to track it down. Slips through two defenders. And again, Barr-Reeve taking a lot of time and now turning the basketball over.
Great play, Tyrae Robinson. Stayed down, moved his feet, didn't go for a fake. Could have been a charge, could have been a block, could have been no call, which is what it was. Ball to Bowman. Great, great stance by Tyrae Robinson, number five.
And Moore again is going to begin the keep away game for Bowman Academy. Here comes the trap. We'll find DeJuan Marrero. Of all the guys on the floor, this is the guy I want the ball in his hands. By Bowman and Robinson.
There's a lot of guys you can want the ball in your hand, but you called it.
Bowman makes it a 20-point lead. Robinson down double figures with 11. Gary well represented here today. The region well represented with Bowman, Wheeler, and Gary Wallace playing in the first three games. When I think of Gary in the state finals, there's obviously so many memories, but the kind of most immediate one that comes to mind is Gary Westside here in 02, because it was about 10,000 folks wearing orange on the one side of Conseco Fieldhouse. Silk Joseph, exclamation point for Bowman Academy. You can celebrate now, Bowman fans, with 2.5 minutes to play. Barr-Reeve come up short. No shame in that today to this quality of opponent. Barr-Reeve's third appearance in the single-A state championship game, and unfortunately they are now gone 0-3 in those appearances. Rebound Marrero, and Bond will track it down and eventually grab the basketball, and it'll be a foul on Barr-Reeve. It'll be one plus the bonus for Christopher Bond. Take a look at Silk Joseph, and I'm sure he's going to save this highlight in his personal resume from now until the day he leaves the earth.
Silk Joseph, really an impressive kid. The entire Bowman team, really impressive. But I have to say for Barr-Reeve, you know, Greg, sitting here courtside, you can see the toughness of Barr-Reeve. You can see why they have such a terrific basketball program. You can see why they've made it to the state finals. You can see why they come through a tough sectional. It's a very impressive program that Coach Hughes has. But unfortunately for them, Bowman Academy just has too much.
A lot of years, this Barr-Reeve team is the best team in single A. This is not one of those years.
No, in a lot of years, Bowman Academy might be as good a team as there is in the state, regardless of class.
30-second timeout is going to be called by Bowman Academy. Just kind of get everybody on the same page, collect their thoughts. Bond will stay in the game to shoot the one plus the bonus. It is now called a full timeout. So we'll step aside as well. Final 2:02 of this one. Bowman Academy on their way to a state championship on the Indiana Cable Network. Players awaiting. They're ready to play the final 202. We got to pay some bills. We got to pay Dockage's salary. Bond to shoot one plus the bonus. Greg Rakestraw from Hometown Sports Indiana. Dan Dockage from 1070 The Fan. Bond misses the free throw. Fight for the loose ball. Both teams have subbed out, and now Bond will be able to have a seat as four to replace him. So let's make everybody's moms and grandmas happy and mention who's on the floor. For Barr-Reeve, the five on the floor, Hunter Knepp, Josh Schwartzentruber, Heath Graber, Jacob Bledsoe, and Jonathan Gingrich are the five on the floor. For Bowman Academy, it is Floyd Hoskins, Darren Gamble, Michael Ford, Elijah Ray, and Kendall Dawson. That was Gingrich who lost the basketball out of bounds to Bowman Academy. And while we're mentioning folks, I'm not sure we've mentioned all three of our officials today, so let me do that now. Gary Weir, Mark Wise, and Jason Hornaday, and Doug Coddington was our alternate for today's game. He'll be the alternate for the 2A game as well. That's quite an honor for those guys to get to these state championships too. We'll interview both the winning coach, Trester Award winner, the presentations of the medals and the championship trophies, all coming up in our postgame show. A minute 23 seconds from now, here on the Indiana Cable Network from Conseco Fieldhouse. Just joining us, Bowman kind of slowly pulled away from the second quarter on. It was a 6-point lead, became eight. What was eight became 12. And that play right there, emblematic of the entire day. Barr-Reeve gets a steal, and Bowman got it right back.
You know, it's hard. You come in late in the game, and the coach wants you to slow it down a little bit. And you're sitting there going, you know what? It's my only chance to play in this game. I'm going to go.
One Schwartzentruber just replaced another one for Barr-Reeve as Matt checks in, replacing his older brother, Josh, who had played earlier in the contest. So all 12 Barr-Reeve Vikings have now played. Steal by Hoskins. Hoskins looking for the reverse layup.
Whoa!
Didn't get the jam. Got the reverse layup.
He went for the reverse, maybe the 360. Didn't quite get there, but got the bucket.
Ray's shot is a block of the freshman and Jacob Bledsoe.
Ray's been really good. Greg Ray came in the first half. I thought he was outstanding as well.
For the rebound. And fouled is Darren Gamble on the drive, and he will shoot two. Let's watch one of the prettiest layups you're ever going to see.
Yeah, let's have a look here. Let's see exactly what was transpiring. Here's the steal. He's getting his steps. He goes with a reverse. I thought maybe he was going with a 360. I think he was just going with the backward flush. Good for him. He got it in.
Well, you were breaking down the dunk contest there for a second. They've got one of those coming up in town this week. You might be able to apply your services.
I thought it was going to be nice. I thought maybe he had a little 360.
You know, on a 9-foot-6 rim, that would have been really nice.
But great.
Two missed free throws by Gamble, and Barr-Reeve will look for a shot, and they'll get it. Basket is made by Jonathan Gingrich, a 6'2 sophomore. Bowman, let's see if they'll fire it up one more time. Marvin Rea says no, and I'm not sure if Dawson's looking at him. Now he is.
Classy move by Marvin.
He says, okay, coach, we won't shoot it again. Bowman Academy, in just their second tournament appearance, has their first state championship. The Bowman Academy Eagles, 74, and the Barr-Reeve Vikings, 52, and hugs and smiles all around for Bowman Academy.
Well, they played exactly as advertised. I mean, they came in, they were aggressive, they were tough, and most importantly, they were all there.
A lot of folks thought that this would happen last year, that in their first year of eligibility, Bowman would get to the state championship game. They were knocked off by Triton in the regional final. And in talking with Marvin Rea about how much that game, that loss, carried over to this season, he simply said, every day. We've thought about that game every day and used that to get here to Conseco Fieldhouse.
Well, he told me the same thing. And as you go through the tournament, they won by 40. They won by 42. They won by 28. They won by 50. They won by 12 against Blackhawk Christian with the Bird kid who's going to Michigan State. They won by 10 against Monroe Central. And then here tonight, they take the game out. That's who they are. I mean, they're a tough, tough basketball team with very talented players that play the absolute perfect way for their kids. And you can see it in their kids' eyes, Greg. They like playing the way they play. They take pride in playing the way they play. They're an aggressive group. Hard to beat.
We'll have the Mental Attitude Award being handed out momentarily. We'll go to Scott Gregg, our PA announcer here at Conseco Fieldhouse, for that announcement.
Your attention, please.
As we'll get the winner and his family
the Indiana High School
together. And in fact, Scott's running now. Let's join him. It's time for the Indiana Farm Bureau Mental Attitude Award ceremony.
Presenting the Arthur L. Trester Mental Attitude Award will be Tim Grove of North Knox High School, a member of the IHSAA Executive Committee.
We would like to first welcome Mr. Greg Churchill, Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance Agency Manager from Crawfordsville, to assist with the presentation of the 2010 Arthur L. Trester Mental Attitude Award for Class A Boys Basketball. A Mental Attitude Award is presented in each of the 20 IHSAA sports. This award is based on scholarship, mental attitude, leadership, and athletic ability. In addition to the award, Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance, a proud corporate partner of the IHSAA, will award a $1,000 scholarship to the winner's school. Since 1989, over $668,000 in college scholarships have been presented by the Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance to deserving high school students in our state. On behalf of the IHSAA, please join us in saying thank you to Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance for its generous support of our student athletes. After we announce the name of the recipient, we invite his parents to join him on the arena floor. The recipient of this award, while a student in grade 12, was nominated by the principal and coach, excelled in mental attitude, athletic ability, scholarship, and leadership during the 4 years of high school, participated as a state finalist in this sport, and was selected by members of the IHSAA Executive Committee. The winner of the 2010 Arthur L. Trester Mental Attitude Award for Class A Boys Basketball is Christian Duncheon.
Christian Duncheon again, the senior ranked number one in his class, is going to enroll at the University of Notre Dame to study pre-medicine. His parents, Tony and Lisa, alongside as well. Again, congratulations to Christian and Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance present a $1,000 scholarship in his honor to the folks at Barr-Reeve High School. Post-game coverage comes your way next here on the Indiana Cable Network. As we return to Conseco Fieldhouse, the runner-up medals being presented to the Barr-Reeve Vikings. Again, the Vikings had a fantastic season. They will finish 24-4. Bowman Academy, the winner today, 74-52. Let's go courtside to Dan Dockich.
We're here with Kristen Duncheon, the winner of the Trester Award, and his mother. Congratulations, Kristen. I know the game didn't go the way you want, but what a great career, and congratulations on a tremendous award.
Thank you. This is a tremendous honor, and I'm just fortunate to be here. It's been a great experience, and it's a very humbling moment.
I'm going to let you go. I know you have to get up there and get your award. Mr. and Mrs. Duncheon, you have to be so proud of your son.
We are very proud, yes.
Yeah, very proud. Thank you very much.
Your son has been like president of everything, the Honor Society, class president, going to Notre Dame. This basketball season, it didn't end the way you wanted, but that's just one part of it. He has a great future ahead.
Right. Well, basketball is always a wins and losses, and this had to end up as a loss today, but he's very excited to win this, and I'm sure he's very humbled by it. It's a great award.
Well, Bowman's a very good team. There's not much more we can do. They're extremely athletic. As far as the award, I'm very happy for Christian. He's put a lot of time and effort in it, so I'm happy for him.
Well, congratulations. Back to you, Greg.
Thank you very much, Danny. And that family's seen a lot of good Barry basketball the last several years. His older brother, Nick, a member of the 2007 State Runners-Up as well. More post-game coverage comes your way next on ICN. The winner's medals being presented to Bowman Academy. Dan Dockich will be standing by with head coach Marvin Rea of Bowman Academy coming up in just a little bit. individual scores today for Bowman Academy. DeJuan Marrero, 12 in the second half. He had 17. Christopher Bond with 15. Christopher did most of his damage in the first half, had just 3 points in half number two. Tyrae Robinson had 11 to round out the double-figure scores for Bowman Academy. Let's go courtside. Dan Dockett standing by with our winning head coach.
The second man ever to win a Trestor Award and now a state champion as a coach, Marvin Rea. Congratulations. You said it at halftime. Wear them out and go win it in the fourth quarter.
Exactly. That was our game plan, with to come out and dictate the tempo of the game. I'm not a scoreboard watcher. I'm a player watcher. And I saw where they were a little fatigued, so my game plan was, let's use our strength with this up and down the court. Let's get up more shots. And by the fourth quarter, let me coach at that point. And towards the end of the game, I was able to do what I do. It's a chess match. And I was able to bring the ball out. Our guys did an excellent job at running up and down, and we wore those guys down.
Coach, congratulations. I'll let you go get in line. Back to you, Greg.
We had to let Coach go to go get his medal and go get his state championship plaque. As again, the Bowman Academy Eagles, first-time state champions. More post-game coverage comes your way next on the Indiana Cable Network. The Barr-Reeve again getting their state runner-up championship picture taken. The Bowman Academy pictures and net cutting will be happening in just a matter of moments. Take a look now at our Comcast high-speed play of the game, and that couldn't be any more fitting, because Bowman did everything at high speed today. And how about this dunk by Silk Joseph?
Well, they did everything, including this. Get out, get down the floor, steal the basketball. Really impressive performance on the defensive end.
And if you're going to have one field goal, that's the field goal to have. Joseph finished with 6, that dunk, and 4 from the free throw line. Again, thanks to Comcast for presenting our high-speed play of the game. The nets are coming down. Bowman Academy, your single-A state champs on the Indiana Cable Network. There you see Bowman Academy again. For the victors go to the spoils. You get that picture with the state championship trophy. Nets are already down, and we'll begin their celebration off the court here momentarily. Greg Regstra and Dan Dock is back with you on the Indiana Cable Network. And had a couple of guys to choose from for Bowman Academy, Dan, for our Taco Bell player of the game. We're going to go with Christopher Bond, certainly an excellent choice.
Yeah, as advertised, he came in. He was our featured player to start the game. 15 points, 9 rebounds, 4 on the offensive end, 4 steals. But, you know, Greg, even more than that, he kind of patrolled inside. He came from the top of the zone to block shots. He was very aggressive. Here you see a steal against the press. Very versatile and very impressive young man.
Again, congratulations to Christopher, state champ, as well as our Taco Bell player of the game. Again, the stat line, you saw it, 15 points, 9 rebounds, 4 steals, 2 blocks, 2 assists. More postgame comes your way next on the Indiana Cable Network. Postgame party continues here for Bowman Academy. And you know, it's funny, they get to celebrate for about 10 minutes because the nets are already up. The 2A teams need to come out here. When you're the first act of 4, you get to have your party in the locker room and out in the lobby, because we got more basketball to play here at Conseco Field.
What time is it? It's 12:30. This is going to be a really nice day for the people of Bowman Academy. On the other end, you get to win. You get to hang out and have an awesome day and feel good about yourself. And they should. They play tremendous.
Park Tudor, coached by a gentleman that has had NBA and collegiate head coaching experience, Ed Schilling, against the Wheeler Bearcats. Both teams making their first appearance in a state championship game. More postgame coverage next on ICF. Again, there you see the new nets. They'll go through 4 pair of those today for each of the games. And you know, at the state finals meetings, you have to be very organized about these things. You're told you have one person that gets to go up on each end and cut down the entire net. There's just no time to do it any other way. So look at the final stats here for this one, Dan. Again, 74-52, Bowman Academy a winner. Barr-Reeve out-rebounded Bowman Academy by a score of 40-36. But the undoing of Barr-Reeve, as it is for most teams that play Bowman, turnovers. Barr-Reeve gave it away 24 times.
They gave it away 24 times, and they didn't shoot it. To beat a team like Bowman Academy, you have to shoot a high percentage. Barr-Reeve, 33% for the ball game, 0 for 4 on threes in the second half, 17 of 51 overall. We said from the get-go that Bowman wanted to get up 50 shots. They ended up getting up 64 shots, shot 47%. So you combine the turnovers, higher shooting percentage for Bowman Academy. That's why we have a 22-point victory.
That horn means that we're wrapping up game number one. Our coverage of game two is not too far away. We'll put a capper on this one next on the Indiana Cable Network. For our single-A broadcast today, again, Bowman Academy takes home their first state championship, knocking off Barr-Reeve by a score of 74-52. Coming up next on the Indiana Cable Network, 26-1 Wheeler against 15-10 Park Tudor. That game will tip just before 1 o'clock, so stay with us about 15, 20 minutes from now. Dan and I and our entire Indiana Cable Network crew will be right back here at Conseco Fieldhouse. Congratulations to the Bowman Academy Eagles, single-A state champs. Back with more in just a few minutes on the Indiana Cable Network.